I've been daily driving Ubuntu 24.04 on my main computer, a Lenovo ThinkPad T440s with 4th gen Intel Core CPU, and so far it's been wonderful. Can't ask for much more from a Linux distribution. It's early days, but I've already started wondering what the best supported computer setup could be after October 2025, when Windows 10 Home and Pro support ends. Windows 10 is still supported for now, and it's mostly been working great. But if life taught me one thing, is that you should be prepared instead of procrastinating. I want to keep a supported operating system on my main computer. If I didn't care about that stuff, I'd just install Windows 7. And if you're one of those people who say an unsupported OS is fine if you have a firewall and you're careful on the internet, I agree with you, which is why I still use it on other computers sometimes. But I refuse to do that on my everyday machine. That's stupid. So I've begun doing some research on an alternate support OS without buying new hardware. Yes, the old OS won't suddenly start becoming super unsafe, but I wanted to try something newer anyway. I like Linux, and it's nowhere near as complicated as Hackintosh, but it is more complicated than Windows. There are so many distributions to choose from, you get overwhelmed, but I decided to stay in familiar territory. I first began using Linux back in 2008 with Ubuntu 8.04 on my Acer Aspire 1690 laptop. Ubuntu was the most popular Linux distro back then. It was very interesting because it was different and free, and also because it was that easy to dual boot Windows and Linux back then. But the novelty wore off after a few weeks because many applications I wanted required Windows. Since then, I've explored dozens of distros over the years, but never ditched macOS on my Mac or Windows on my other computers. Earlier this year, I used Linux Mint 21 daily for about a month on my 2009 MacBook Pro, and it was pretty good, but that older hardware is a little limiting sometimes, even though it's still great for basic tasks. So this time I wanted to try a Linux distro on my more powerful laptop, and what better opportunity than the brand new Ubuntu 24.04 long-term support release? Ubuntu is not everyone's favorite Linux distro anymore, but it's still popular, and I don't see any deal breakers in it, so I downloaded it on release day. April 25th, 2024, and installed it in a secondary drive partition on my ThinkPad T440s. So now my main computer is dual booting Windows 10 and this new Ubuntu. I spent about an hour setting it up for my needs, and here we are nearly a month later. So how is it? Do I miss Windows? Yes, because I don't have much against it, but Linux is not a bad experience at all. It does require using the terminal sometimes, but much less often than the past. So far, I only had to use it for the TLP power management driver to set up battery charge thresholds, and for NeoFetch, of course. The Snap applications are fine. They're not slow at all, and they update automatically. The new Snap store has an icon where the shopping bag handle looks like a large speck of dust, but it works fine, except it looks corrupted sometimes. I haven't seen this happen on any other Snap app, like Firefox. The TrackPoint seems to handle a little worse, regardless of how acceleration is set, which is similar to the enhanced pointer precision setting in Windows. But I could get used to it. One difference is that if you press the middle mouse button without scrolling, it acts like pressing the scroll wheel on a regular mouse, which doesn't happen in Windows. The built-in speakers sound much worse, because there's no proprietary Dolby equalizer. But if you install the app Easy Effects and install this Convolver effect available online, you can get it sounding a little better, although still not as good as the real thing. For my USB sound card, the first time you plug it in, you have to set it as default manually, but after that, it automatically toggles between it and the built-in speakers whenever you plug it in or unplug it. And you have to set Easy Effects to only apply the audio effect for the internal speakers. If you turn on keyboard backlight, it remembers that setting even after you turn off the display or go to sleep mode or shut down, unlike Windows. Sleep mode has been working perfectly so far, even though just 1 month may not be enough to tell. Are the sleep mode crashes I've been experiencing just an issue with Windows? Maybe. The fingerprint reader works, but only for logging in and unlocking, not for other tasks that require root privileges. And it also doesn't work when unlocking from sleep mode for some reason. Now that I don't have macOS anymore, and this laptop doesn't need any proprietary drivers on Linux, I enable TPM 2.0 and Secure Boot, just to see how well Ubuntu works with them. One issue is that the GRUB menu is invisible when compatibility support module is turned off. The solution is to disable GRUB graphical mode by editing its configuration file. The TPM isn't really useful since I haven't actually configured it for anything, but now it's enabled. The thing that everyone keeps mentioning when talking about Windows 11's absurd requirements. even though it's not the worst. Here's a screen recording test. And here you can also hear the quality of this laptop's built-in microphone. On Windows, you can improve it a little bit with the voice recognition sound effect, but of course it's not available on Linux. It seems to use a lot of CPU, because on Windows with these same settings in OBS, the encoding doesn't get overloaded. I'm using a few GNOME extensions, namely dash to panel, which adds this Windows-like taskbar, desktop clock, which adds that on the desktop, and Astro Monitor to monitor the CPU and RAM usage. As you can see, Open Broadcaster software is the one that uses the most CPU right now, and there's quite a bit of free memory. And this is also supposed to show the temperatures. I've enabled them in the extension settings, but they don't show up. If you hover over this tiny blank space, they do appear. Bat0 is the battery voltage, core temp is some temperatures, and ThinkPad with lowercase p is some more readings, which should be accurate. Now the CPU is quite hot because it's at 100% usage, but normally it's less than 50 degrees Celsius. Here's the system info with some more details. I'm using X11 instead of Wayland because I'm using the Redshift application to lower the color temperatures in the evening and at night. The reason I'm using Redshift instead of the built-in GNOME Nightlight is because you can suspend it for a limited amount of time. The GNOME Nightlight only lets you suspend it until sunrise. Sometimes I open the menu here and expect a shutdown option, but it's not here. You have to open the settings menu here to log out and shut down. I enabled the large text accessibility setting, which is equal to setting the font scaling to 125%. It doesn't slow down or use higher resolution, unlike using fractional scaling. While I'm here, I can show you something else. In the other location settings, my SMB network shares do not appear. But if you enter its IP address or server name in the box below, it works just fine. For example, SMB:// Raspberry Pi. Then you can open your network share and bookmark it on the sidebar on the left. This experience is a little different because previously, when I was trying Mint 21 on my old MacBook, I always enjoyed going back to Windows on my less old ThinkPad because it was a more powerful computer. But now there's no hardware difference. Because this Ubuntu is a clean installation with fewer programs, it's a little faster, and I want to spend more time with it. But not everything is set up. I have some special workflows that just can't be integrated in Linux. And I haven't even tried video games, because I'm not a gamer. But if you want a Windows alternative that isn't Chrome OS Flex, most modern Linux distros are definitely viable for daily use for most computer users. Speaking of updates, Ubuntu does have automatic ones, but from the Snap Store instead of a regular software updater. You may get a warning to restart, but you can delay it for a while, just like Windows. So far, I never had to update manually, so Ubuntu updates have improved. You can basically set it and forget it. So that's it for now. In conclusion, I still like to use Windows, but Ubuntu is not bad at all. Not perfect, but nothing is it? If you've tried this new version of Ubuntu, I'd like to hear your thoughts on it, or any other feedback if you want. Thank you for watching.